My name is Maria Nagaka, and I am a Principal Product Manager on the Microsoft Foundry team. Thank you so much for joining us at AI Dev Days on this cold December, if you're in New York like myself, for the MCP Building Tool-Aware Agents. So for context, let's start with what MCP even stands for. It stands for Model Context Protocol. And over the course of these few minutes that we have together, I am going to try my best to tell you how you can use it today to build more context-aware agents. So let's start from the beginning. What is an agent? Beyond being the buzzword of the year, at its core, an agent is simply a program where you allow an LLM to help you decide the control and flow of the program. Now, think of it like a microservice that executes on a task and achieves a specific business outcome. But in the world of AI, the program goes from being deterministic to non-deterministic. And this is where tools become really handy. We have retrieval, which is things like RAG. We have actions, which is steps to be taken. And we have memory, which is over time, can our agent effectively remember the skills from the past, things that it has done to drive better outcomes? And when you put all of that together, that provides for more grounded results and outputs for your solution, for your business, for your experience. Now, we've talked about tools and tool calling, but the way people connected to tools was very bespoke. There was no standard way. Everybody was doing it their own way. And this is where MCP came into play. So MCP stands for the Model Context Protocol. Earlier last week, it celebrated its first birthday. And it's built by Anthropic. It was built to mend the gap between the way agents were calling and using tools. But it's not just Anthropic that has embraced this. It's not just Microsoft. It's Google, it's OpenAI, it's Docker, it's AWS, it's Hugging Face, and so many more that we can even fit on the slide. Us at Microsoft have been very involved in the open to improve and support and grow the protocol. And we currently have a few of our members here at Microsoft who sit on the steering committee. So with MCP, we are moving towards a unified and secure way in the way agents access tools, data across enterprises, across your solutions. So let's start with what is MCP? MCP is a standardized way AI assistants and agents securely connect to tools, data, and services. Think of it as a universal translator that allows AI tools like GitHub Copilot in VS Code, or GitHub Copilot in IntelliJ, or M365, Claude, and so many different MCP clients to communicate and access external data. So what does this mean? You heard me mention MCP clients. MCP clients are the interface in which you interact with an agent. It could be a chat interface like Claude. It could be a code editor like VS Code. It could be your AI application just leveraging tools to create an automated task. Using the MCP standard protocol, it then accesses a set of MCP servers. MCP servers can do things like access data and file stores. They can access developer tools like the GitHub MCP server, the Playwright MCP server, the Azure MCP server. It can access productivity tools like Notion. It can access design tools like Figma, all in a standard way that enables you to have a more robust and more complete experience. So when it comes to building MCP servers, there are two types of MCP servers that you can build. You can build a local MCP server that communicates over standard I/O. And with MCP servers that are local, you can think of them as running locally on your machine, having access to local files. This gives you things like provides low latency access to large amounts of files, for example. But then you also have remote MCP servers. And this is where we see a bulk of businesses and people building their MCP servers. This remote MCP server is hosted externally on the cloud, right? And communicates over HTTP/SSE. It provides the AI with a scalable, centralized access to external APIs, company database, and web services, which is accessible by multiple users or agents. Now, we've talked a lot about what is an MCP server, but I would like to show you how I personally have found really great value in using MCP servers to be incredibly productive as a product manager here at Microsoft. As a product manager here at Microsoft, we have to write a lot of weekly reports. Now, one of the reports that I was thinking about recently was Aspire is new and Aspire has docs. And how well are our docs doing when we look at the data coming from GitHub? How well are we doing across the market? And typically, when I would do something like that, it would take me a couple of days. But I wanted to show you how I'm doing this using a markdown file and MCP servers. So in this demo, you'll see I have three phases. One of the phases is to access the data, do the research, generate the report, then use Playwright to test that report. So the first thing I'm going to do is attach the markdown to my GitHub Copilot experience. I'm going to hit it, and it's going to read the markdown and start generating the information. The first to do is to analyze the GitHub information by using the GitHub MCP server and looking at our specific completed tasks. The next one, it's going to use another MCP server to do the market research. How well are we doing with the rest of the ecosystem? And the next one is going to build a tool that isn't an MCP server, but treating it as a tool to generate the HTML report. Then finally, we're going to use Playwright to test it and make sure that it is looking and functioning in the way that we like. And there we have it. We have a complete report, right? And I can go and run this report as many times as I want. And I can share it with my team. I can share it with my boss. I can even share it with the community so they know that we are listening to their concerns. So that's an example of how I use MCP servers. But let's talk about how we at Microsoft are building and enabling people to build MCP servers. So at Microsoft, we have made a big bet on MCPs. We have MCPs across Microsoft that we build first parties. We have Azure MCP. We have the Foundry Tools MCP, the GitHub MCP, the Azure Logic Apps, Agent 365, and so many more. We're also enabling multiple ways for people to build and publish their own MCP servers, whether they have an existing Logic app and they want to expose it as an MCP server, a way to manage them privately using Azure API Center, using Azure Functions to build them, hosting them in app services or Azure Container Apps. And then you can call these MCP servers from any MCP client. And above all, we're making it effortless for you to secure and govern your MCP servers with Azure API management and Entra ID. Now, this year at Ignite, and I was really excited about this work, we introduced the Foundry Tools. Foundry Tools has over 1,000 tools from public catalogs and Microsoft partners that you can leverage in your Foundry agent today. You can build and share these via a private tool catalog that you can host for yourself,
Or you can add SIMP through a public one, which is the Foundry Tools one or the GitHub one, which we'll talk about a little bit later. We have worked with multiple partners in order to build a robust and diverse group of tools, from analytics to developer to data and so many more, just to make sure that you can build the agents you need to solve the problems that you need solved. We've talked a lot about building MCP servers, using MCP servers, and the different types of MCP servers. Let's talk about how we manage MCP servers today. So I want to start with where the problem started. When the MCP became really popular at the beginning of this year, there were so many different registries in the ecosystem. So that meant that every single developer had to deploy their MCP server into various registries so as to make sure they reached as many people as possible. We wanted to streamline the discovery of those MCPs. And to do that, we had three different registries that we worked with. The first one was the open source registry. Built in the open with Anthropic, you can see today on github.com/MCP, this is the MCP registry for developers. It is where you make your awesome MCP available to the entire ecosystem. But we do understand when it comes to enterprises, they want more of a curated list of MCPs that have been approved by their IT admin. You also might have a set of internal MCP servers that you do not want to have accessed by the grander public. And this is where things like Azure Foundry, GitHub Copilot, Azure API Center, as well as GitHub can provide you with that experience. And finally, you have the on-device registry from the Windows team. The on-device registry on the Windows team provides you with a common place on your machine to manage MCPs securely. And these are all accessible for people today. Now, we touched on the concept of a private registry. Why is that important? The private registry provides you with a tailored enterprise experience for organizations to develop, host, and distribute MCPs relevant to their business. You also have a central governance mechanism that allows for IT administrators within your tenant to manage which MCPs are allowed or blocked. And because we've streamlined this entire experience, it enables your business and the developers and the business managers who want to leverage MCPs an accelerated way to develop because you have provided them with a curated experience. Now, since I've walked you through the various types of registries, let's explore what it would look like to take your MCP code from code to registry. And for my final demo, I'm going to be looking at creating and deploying an MCP server through the lens of an enterprise setting, leveraging Azure API Center. Now, building an MCP server is simple, and you can look at this code yourself. It's available in the URL below. In this demo, what I'm doing is building a simple tool that reads and writes data into Azure Blob Storage that I can easily deploy using Azure Functions. So once I have deployed my MCP server onto Azure Functions, I can make it accessible to my business using Azure API Center. In this sample, we have a Zava tool private catalog. And once I have it successfully deployed into API Center, I now have it accessible in my own private catalog, which is great for your business. I connect it to an agent. And once it's successfully connected to an agent, I can use it in an agent of my choice. Now, in this example, what I'm going to be doing is looking at various different transactions that are happening in my business. So it's going to say, how many sales did Eli make? Then it's going to run, look at internal data, grab the information. Once you approve it, it generates all the records. You can then also retrieve a specific record This is all pulling it out from our Cosmos database. And then once that's run, we should see the results. And there you have it. In just a few lines of code, using things like Azure functions, writing it in Python, I have successfully built an MCP server. I have accessed it in my private catalog using API Center. I have attached it to an agent in Foundry. And this is ways that we are finding that businesses today are successfully building meaningful agents. And with that being said, thank you so much for joining my talk. And I hope you build an MCP server soon.